do you have your own website? Have you ever wondered if it's important to have it and why? Do you know what are the rules of the perfect website? Let's talk about this today. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel, we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today, we'll talk about how to create a perfect website. And here, I want to highlight that no matter if you are a business owner or you freelance from time to time, you should definitely have your own website. But before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, so you are sure you won't miss any future tutorials. Okay, so let's start from the question. Why should we even worry about having a website? Is it really such an important issue? First of all, lots of the time your website is your first impression. It's lots of the time the first contact with a client, and you don't want to mess this up. Similarly, as in human relationships, the first impression matters the most. People will perceive your company through what they see on your website, and it's in your hands how they will see you. Also, your website is your welcome for the visitors. So you can think about your website like about your home when you ask your guests, in this case your visitors of the page, to come in and look around. And finally, your website should be a filter. Filter for what? Filter that selects your ideal clients from the ones your service is not for. It's a great way to avoid wasting time for both sides, you and the clients that don't look for solutions you offer. Okay then, so what is the goal of a website? It's quite simple. If your clients visit your website, you want them to contact you. Now let me tell you my 10 tips on how to create a perfect website. This is a base to every business. Knowing your client, knowing who you target to, what are his or her characteristics, who this person is, and if your service is suitable to your client. And based on this, you create a marketing offer. You know how to present your service, how to advertise it, how to sell it, and so on. And this is why we talk about this in detail in our first module related to business called Sales Psychology in our business training, as this is a foundation to every action you do in business. I put the link to the course in the corner in case you want to check it out. As you know your client's avatar, then you can start thinking about your website. And the first step is answering the question, how do I want people to perceive me or my brand? Do I want my clients to see my brand as a professional high-end service or humorous young team or a team with lots of experience and knowledge? And based on this, we can create a concept of our website. The truth is that it doesn't matter how great you are, what you do or what you did, how many awards you have gotten, how many jobs your company have done. If your client cannot see it in your brand, what matters is what your visitors think about you after visiting your website. What their perception about your brand is based on this. And this is your role to make it right. Remember that your client doesn't want to hire a company or a personal brand. He wants to hire people, a person behind it. So it's important for you to create an impression on the website that there are actual, real people behind it. Your goal is for your clients to think about you or your company when they will need the kind of service you provide. So you want to stick in their minds, to be memorable. So here it's important to create a great impression, to create a uniqueness of your brand, to create a positive memory about your brand in their minds. And this leads us to the next point. Next point is adding value. How can we do this? By creating a great experience on our website, by showing ourselves as an authority and experts in the field, by making it clear that choosing us has benefits to our clients, and finally, making our clients confident about choosing us and creating impression of pleasure to work with us. What is this about? Well, do not confuse your client. This is the last thing you want to do. Make it clear about who you are, what you do, how you do it, and why he should choose you. And everything on this website should be consistent with this message. Copywriting, website style, color, fonts, and so on. And here, I should mention one of the most important concepts in web design. Visual hierarchy, which means the order in which visitor process information on your website. And here services like Squarespace can be super handy as you can edit existing templates which are already nicely designed. And this is the easiest way to create a professional website. If you're interested in their service, I put the link in the description below the video. Anyway, here using different font sizes and colors to distinguish headlines, titles, and descriptions is a key. This way, you will help your viewer to move around your website, but also keep him engaged with your content. The next important tip is to make sure that you keep harmony on your website. So the same as in the design or creating an image, you should keep in mind composition, colors, and general balance. Keep in mind hierarchy of information, highlighting what is important, not using too much text, not too long paragraphs. Too many different fonts will make your website look unstructured and unprofessional. This is why using templates make life easier. The goal is to make your website nice to look around and to avoid overwhelming your client. Your website should be easy to read. If your visitors cannot read your text on the website, your message is not going through. So do not make too many moving objects and too many colors. Do not confuse the reader. Make it clean. Divide long paragraphs into smaller parts. Use bullet points to break out large chunks of text. Use blank spaces. Keep in mind the style of the font to be easy to read and not too small. The same as I told you with creating visualizations. If you are not sure if to add something or not, ask yourself simple questions. Do I really need this on my page? Does it help me with supporting my message? Choose functionality on top of creativity. You need to meet your client's expectations. He knows the certain structure of the website and he expects to see something similar. So the website should be intuitive and easy to follow. Also, remember to make your website responsive, which means that it will be automatically resized and reshuffled to fit the dimensions of particular devices, notebooks, tablets, and phones. And finally, optimize your images. It matters a lot in creative fields. If you put lots of high-res images on your website, it will slow it down. So remember to save your images in the correct format, specially dedicated to webs. But if you use services like Squarespace, it will typically automatically optimize your images for you, so you won't have to worry about it. Okay, I hope you find my 10 tips to create a perfect website helpful. At the end, I would like to invite you to check out our business training, where we'll discuss particular pages of the website step by step. But not only, also we will talk about different important topics like pricing, managing clients, project, marketing, sales, and much, much more. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye-bye!